ปองปองอยู่อาร์ my secretary also เนี่ย thank you นะคะ
ครับ
โอเค then ปอง you are here okay and then เชนี่พิชยะพิชยะพิชยะวัฒนะเทสานันพิชยะวัฒนะเทสานันชยกฤตชยกฤตชยกฤตสถาวรินทุปิติชัยคูสว่างศรี
ครับมาครับ
ครับ and then this is order for the presentation of them which will be on the 3rd of May okay from 5 p.m. สิทธิพลชัยเสนา
ครับผมมาครับ
ครับโมสธนพลเรืองทองธนพลเรืองทองวัชรฤทธิ์กลัดแก้ว
มาครับ
ครับวริศราวงทวีพิทยากุลวริศรา
ค่ะ
ฮารุณะนากาอิ
มาค่ะ
ค่ะธัญชนจันทโรจน์วานิช
มาค่ะ
ค่ะวัชรพลจิงวาจาม
าครับ
ครับผมณัฐพัฒน์ภัทรเปรมเจริญพิชาพัฒน์พันณเชษฐ
์มาค่ะ
ค่ะพานุพงษ์เพชรบริสุทธิ
์มาค่ะ
ค่ะพบพรสพบพรส
มาครับ
ค่ะสัญญพงษ์ประภาพันธ์พิไล
สัญญพงษ์เข้าไปสอบสัมภาษณ์ฝึกงานอาจารย์ครับเขาก็ขอผมมาบอกอาจารย์ครับ
สิมิลันเชี่ยวกิจสุกริตตัน
มาครับ
ครับหัวหลิว
มาครับ
ครับสาริยาสาธุภาค
มาค่ะ
โอเคโซ
อาจารย์ครับนันทพัฒน์นันทพัฒน์มานะครับ
นัท
พัทระเจริญ
พัทระเปรมเจริญโอเคครับ
อาจารย์คะหนูถามนิดนึงค่ะแล้วโปรเจกต์อะค่ะให้ส่ง21มีนาใช่ปะคะหรือว่าวันเดียวกับพรีเซนเทชันเลย
ส่งก่อนลูกส่งก่อนจะได้เสร็จงานแต่ว่าพรีเซนเราเอาทีหลังเลยพรีเซนที่หลังเพราะต้อง
ค่ะค่ะมันคือวันที่21ใช่ไหมคะที่ต้องส่ง
ใช่
ๆโอเคค่ะขอบคุณค่ะ
ค่ะขอบคุณค่ะ
จ้าครับพิชยามาครับเมื่อกี้กดเข้าไปแล้วครับ
พิชยาวัฒนะเทสานันโอเคค่ะ and then you see on Monday 10 we have a holiday พืชมงคลAnd then on Monday, 26th of April is okay. No problem. Monday, 19th April, okay. No problem. I can teach. Monday, 12th April, Songkran holiday. I try to find the day that we should prepare for makeup class if I cannot catch up, okay?And then Monday 5 April okay no problem I can teach however on Monday 29 March I have to cancel class okay Audi please note it and write it down on our line group นะคะ Monday 29 March class is cancelled
โอเคค่ะ
Monday 22nd March okay. And then Monday 15 March class is cancelled. Monday 15 March class is cancelled. Monday 8 March is midterm exam. Class is cancelled.Monday next week, Monday 1st of March. Okay, I can teach. So that there are about 3 times that I cancel and it's a holiday. So that I would like to spend the time to make up class. So that I would like to ask you which day that you are okay. So I would like you to propose the day.If anyone has the problem, you can tell me, okay? For example, Are you okay on Thursday evening, for example, on March 18, Thursday, March 18, from 4:30, anyone has the problem or not?4:30 to 6:30, something like this. Thursday evening, okay, right? Okay, so, Adi, note down. I will prepare, for example, 3 times, okay? 3 and 4 times, for example, in order to reserve your time first. The first makeup is on Thursday 18th.March from 4:30 to 6:30. Okay. First one.
Okay, ค่ะ
ขอบคุณค่ะ And then number one. And then for example, March.Thursday, March 25, okay? Thursday, March 25, from 4:30 to 6:30 is the second time. I will spare the time about 3 times. This is second. And then...Thursday 1st of April. Thursday 1st of April from 4:30 to 6:30 for the fourth time. Third time. Another time. For example, Thursday 8th April. Thursday 8th April. Okay, that's all.Okay. Thank you, everyone. So we will do like this, okay? And then I will continue.
อาจารย์ค่ะ one make up คืออันนี้ชัวร์ๆเลยใช่ไหมคะ
I have the problem of microphone. Look, can you ask me by typing in the line?You can hear me, but I cannot hear you. It's quite strange today for me. I cannot hear you. Odi, can you?
ค่ะอาจารย์เดี๋ยวหนูพิมพ์ไปหาค่ะ
Can you put it in our line group?
โอเคค่ะ
okay so I continue นะคะ I continue today I have the problem of the software I cannot hear you very well I don't know why I do the same thingI will. I will share screen. Okay, then this is what we are talking about last time, right? We talk about the analytical property of EY curve, right? And Julajit, Pong, is this here or not that I stopped last time?
ไม่ชัวร์ครับ
จุลจิตไอไม่ได้ยินอยู่เลย
ไม่ชัวร์ครับ
จุลจิต
ครับ
ไอไม่ได้ยินอยู่ไอสอนถึงตรงนี้ใช่ไหมลูก
ไม่แน่ใจครับอาจารย
์ Can you type it in our line group I cannot hear you
ผมได้ยินจุลจิตนะครับอาจารย์
ไม่แน่ใจฮูโน่ฮูโน่ดีครูสอนถึงไหนเล่าถึงนี้ไหม analytical property ใช่ไหมOkay, so that it means that no one follow me. I cannot remember. You cannot remember. No one know. Okay. Thank you. ขอบคุณครับ ขอบคุณลูก I see.Okay, so now we are going to derive, we call that analytical properties of critical flow. What happened? What is the meaning of the analytical property? We will derive and we will have some properties that we can use for application for our engineering work. For example, if we do like this, we want to derive in the case of rectangular cross section to be simple. In this rectangular cross section, we beginning with definition. Definition of specific energy is Y, and then we square over 2G. ทำไมครูมาอยู่ตรงนี้ได้We square over 2G, and then we change V into Q. This is only for rectangular cross section. And then we know that from EY curve that we already derive EY curve. We know that for the property of EY curve, for each curve, we have constant Q. Then,With this kind of thing, we know that we will have E minimum specific energy at the place where critical flow occurs. So it means that when you have one function dy by dx at the minimum point, dy by dx is equal to 0. So we dip dy by dx or dE by dy, which is 0, and we differentiate the first equation. So we get this equation, okay? Dip y equal to 1, dip q square over 2g. Q is constant, 2g is constant, so that we dip y, so that we get this one. So we rearrange the term. We try to formulate all the term into fruit number, okay? So it means that fruit number is what? Fruit number, we define it as v over square root dy. So we rearrange the term. So this one is v square. So that if we rearrange this term, we can have at this point, when dE by dy equal to 0, it means this point. So it means that at this point, when critical flow occur, what we get? We get this one, right? We derive and we get this one. When we have minimum E, we will have velocity equal to dy. And at that point, subscript is critical flow. So we put subscript here, C, C. V is velocity at critical flow. Yc is the depth at critical flow. So that this is the first property. What else? So from this equation B, when we rearrange it like this, from equation B, we rearrange, then it means that y equal to q square over g to the power 1/3. What does it mean? It means that at this point, this is the second property. When we have critical flow, if we want to measure this charge, we want to measure this charge, we measure y, and then this is constant, right? What we get? We get q. This kind of property we use for the equipment so-called Venturi flume and partial flume, two equipment in to application of this one, apply by using this one, Venturi flume, and apply to another flume, partial flume, to make critical cross-section, force it to be critical flow. And when critical flow occur, we can use that one for measuring discharge. So it is the equipment for measuring discharge in open channel flow, in open channel flow for small flume, okay? This is the plan of Venturi flume. When you have the cross section of the flume, normally it is rectangular cross section. However, when this flume go at this point, this is the narrowest point or throat section. So that what you have is here. At this point, you will have critical flow. Critical flow occur at this cross section. We force it to be critical flow. at this cross section so that we measure only y, and then using this property for measuring q, or then we can compute q from this Venturi flume using this property. Okay, partial flume similar, we force it to be critical flow, and we can use the equipment is application. Then from equation D, we rearrange the term, and then we find that at equation D, we have this relationship. And then if we multiply with 1 over 2, this is what we get. So we know that E equal to Y from definition. From definition, E is Y plus V square over 2G. So that if we write it like this, then E at C equal to Y, which is YC, plus this term. Plus this term. And this term is what? Is Y over 2, which is YC. Then it means that here, E equal to 3 over 2 YC, or if you rearrange, you can write it like this. What does it mean? If this is E, this is Y, then we will have 1. This one. This is the trajectory of critical flow, which has the relationship of Y and E like this. So this is third property of critical flow. Okay, so that these three properties we can use for many applications. Okay, so I derive. So what you should know is here. Number one is here. Number 2 is here, and this is number 3. Okay, we have 3 properties like this. Okay, so this is the analytical property of critical flow when it happened at the rectangular cross section. Okay, everyone's good. So next, we already talked about Froude number, right? So Froude number is the number where we want to determine the critical flow, right? We have supercritical flow and subcritical flow. And then now what we want you to know is that when critical flow occur, okay, so the occurrence of critical flow, so I remind you again that critical flow is the flow where velocity equal to inertia due to gravity, or this kind of thing. It means that when Froude number is equal to 1, this is when critical flow occur. And in the case that when critical flow, when we have Froude number greater than 1, it means that our velocity is greater than GD. So it means that you have supercritical flow. However, if you have root number less than 1, it means that your velocity here is less than square root GD. So you have subcritical flow. So now you know critical flow, supercritical flow, and subcritical flow by using root number. When critical flow occur, so in order to know when critical flow occur, it means that when root number is equal to 1. So we can derive by using the following definition. First of all, follow the definition from definition. Total energy equal to Z plus Y plus V square over 2G. Again, in this case, we derive for rectangular cross-section. So that, in this case, we use small q. It means that all of this one is specific energy. So we assume that, assuming that there is no energy loss, so no energy loss, no change of total energy. So dip with respect to this tense is 0. So we dip this equation. So just dz by dx plus dE by dx dip. And then we will see this one. And then what happened? This only this term. Looking at dE by dy. So dip dE by dy, E is y plus q square over 2gy square. So dip this one. When we dip this one, we rearrange it to be root number form. So dE by dy, we rearrange it in term of v square. Then we got this one. And with this one, this is root number, right? Because root number equal to V over square root dy. So this is root number square. So it means that this term dE by dy equal to 1 minus root number square. So substitute this one into this equation. So what we get? This is what we get. What is this? It means that change of the riverbed with respect to x plus change of water level with respect to x multiplied with 1 minus root number square is equal to 0. This one we use to explain change of water level profile when we have a change in riverbed. This equation, we derive this equation beginning with definition of total energy, and then we differentiate. And then finally, what we get, this is what we want to explain. Change of water level with respect to x when we have a change in riverbed, how can we explain? So this one, for example, last time we consider about when we have the change of riverbed. If we have a change of riverbed increasing like this, and if water level coming from subcritical flow, when we have a change of water level of riverbed, increasing of riverbed, then what we have, we proved it last time, we have decreasing of y. If we use this one to explain, we already explained last time. This time we will use this equation to explain. So that with this case, we have dz by dx plus dy by dx 1 minus root number square equal to 0. This is what we have. In this case, we have dz by dx increasing. This is increasing. In this case, at this step, we have subcritical flow. For subcritical flow, root number is less than 1. Less than 1. So 1 minus less than 1. This function is positive. We have to make this equation 0. So this one is already positive. At the second term, this term is already positive. So there is only one left, that is this value. Dy by dx should be negative in order that this one will be negative. Then it will become 0. What does it mean? When dy dz by dx is positive, then if root number, if we have subcritical flow, then dy by dx should be negative, should decreasing, right? So either this equation or EY curve, either or can be used to explain change of water level when we have a change in riverbed. Second case, we already studied last time. This is our second case. That is when you have an elevation of riverbed increasing, but when the flow coming from upstream, like a supercritical flow, then what you have is increasing in your water level. How can we explain by using this equation? In this case, dz by dx is positive because it's increasing. Root number coming from supercritical flow. When we have supercritical flow, root number is greater than 1. When root number is greater than 1, it means that 1 minus something that is greater than 1, then all of this term will be minus. So it means that this is minus already. So dy by dx has to be positive in order to make this equation valid. So it means that when we have riverbed increasing and when upstream coming with supercritical flow, then we will have our water level increasing. The third case, we studied already last time with this curve, EY curve. However, we can also use this one to explain. When we have a decreasing in our riverbed and our water level coming like a subcritical flow at the upstream, when it go to the second cross section, you have water level increasing. How can we use this one to explain? We use this equation to explain. It is that our dz by dx is decreasing. But at the upstream condition, water has the water with the condition of subcritical flow with root number less than 1. 1 minus something that is less than 1. So all of this term is positive. So this one is positive. So it means that only this one dy by dx has to be negative. Negative, ไม่ใช่ positive นะจ๊ะdy by dx minus this one has to be plus, right? So it has to be plus. This one should be positive, sorry. This is minus. All of this term should be positive, right? So it means that if water levelat upstream coming with the subcritical flow root number less than 1, so this is less than 1, 1 minus something less than 1, it is positive, then this one we need it to be positive because it is negative, so this one has to bePositive, then you have an increasing in water level. And the last one. We already studied last time with EY curve. So when you have your riverbed decreasing like this,water coming with supercritical flow condition, then you will have a decreasing in water level. This one can be explained by using this equation. dz by dx decreasing. Root number, supercritical flow.Supercritical flow, root number is greater than 1. So 1 minus something that is greater than 1. So all of this term is minus. So that this one, this will be minus. This is minus, so it should be plus. So in order to make this one plus, this one should be minus.Then you will have a decreasing in your water level. This one should be minus because this is minus already, นะคะ. This one is minus already. This all second term, this one have to be plus. This one already minus. So only one left, dy by dx should be.Minus in order to keep this one plus. So it means that your water level has to be decreasing. Briefly, what I told you last time, we use EY curve to explain 4 cases. When we have riverbed increasing, what happened? When we have riverbed decreasing, what happened?This time, I use the equation, dynamic equation, to explain you when we have a change in riverbed, what happened up to water level. So you can use both equation. Okay, that's all what I want to explain you. And this equation has to be used later on in last chapter. Okay, so when we go to that one, I will not derive this equation again. Okay, we use this equation later on. Okay, so that it means that everyone understand. Okay or not?
Okay, sir.
Thank you, crab. So next, and when critical fall cannot occur. Let's see. We use this one again. When you have horizontal bed, what does it mean? Horizontal bed. This is technical term. Horizontal bed. It means no slope. Slope is zero. If I want to describe in terms of mathematics, slope is zero. Is there is no change of river bed, which is with respect to distance. No change of river bed. No change of river bed with respect to distance. This is mathematical speaking, mathematically speaking, but human being speak horizontal bed. When water coming with the river with no slope, it's coming with y. If you want to use this equation, let's see this equation again. This equation, dz by dx plus dy by dx 1 minus root number square equal to 0. In this case, as we said, horizontal bed, right? In this case, water coming with, you will see later on, water will coming with, we call that normal depth. Normal, normal, not abnormal, normal, normal. We call normal depth. In normal situation, normal depth, yn. So in this case, normal depth, and there is there is no change in water level. No change in water level. What does it mean? No change in water level. Dy by dx equal to 0. So we have only this one. So it means that 0 cannot multiply with 0. 0 cannot multiply with 0. We have only this one left. So it means that we cannot have root number equal to 1. What does it mean? It means that critical fall cannot occur with this situation. Okay, so it means that if we use this equation to describe when we have horizontal bed, critical fall cannot occur. Okay? Okay, so we can say that critical flow cannot occur when we have flow on horizontal bed. So this is what I want to say by using equation to explain. And when we have critical flow, first case, if we have this one is our reservoir, And when we have water level above the crest of our reservoir, and water is flowing down like this. So, what we have here at the crest, this is crest. What does it mean at the crest? Mathematically speaking, if you see, when we study mathematics, if this is fx, if this is x, so here at the crest maximum point, or here minimum point, divide by dx is zero, right? This is the same, but in this case, if this is datum, so it means that dz by dx equal to zero is the crest. At the crest point, mathematically speaking, dz by dx is equal to zero, that is the crest. Okay, at this point, what happened? When we looking at water level, we will see that water level, when it go out from our reservoir, we have a change in water level here at the crest, a change in water level. Mathematically speaking, it means that dy by dx is not equal to zero. No, no, no. Because you have a change in water level. So if you use the same equation to explain, that is dz by dx plus dy by dx 1 minus root number square equal to 0. In this case, at the crest, mathematically speaking, is this one is 0. And you have here dy by dx, which is not zero, right? So only one chance that this equation will be true, that is root number has to be one. Root number has to be one. It means that there is occurrence of critical flow, right? So briefly, if we use this equation to explain, at the crest, we have a change in water level, root number has to be 1. Then critical flow occur at the crest. Okay? This is the occurrence of critical flow. So normally, at the crest of reservoir, we will have staff gate to measure water level here. And then when we know water level here, then we substitute in the equation, what we get? Q. Why we get Q? Because it is critical flow. We have Q as a function of YC, right? Just substitute value of YC, then you can compute Q. So at this point, we can measure what is the flow rate that go out from our reservoir. Another one, this one. This is what we have at the Venturi flume. This is Venturi flume. Venturi flume, what we have here is, this is the plan. Water coming like this. We have at the throat section. At throat section, it means that at this point, this is throat section, we will have critical depth. If we use this equation, if we use, this curve to explain, this is the relationship between E and Y, EY curve. We already studied that with this curve. Each curve, we have Q constant, right? and Q increasing this is Q1 this one is increasing the green one right this one also increasing Q1 Q2 Q3 is increasing why it increasing because we have this one B is narrow down until it is narrowest here, right? We have constant Q, but we have B that is smaller, right? And then Q is maximum, bigger, right? So that when we have the term of Q like this. And if we use this one at the first time, why? Before coming, why here? Before going into our ventral flow, it is here. This point Y2. When it go into ventral flow, as I already said, Q is increasing, so it's coming like this. It will pass from this one to another one to another one. And then after that, going out, B is increasing, right? Then Q, now Q is reducing, coming here like this. So it means that at each point, we have a change of Q. And at the narrowest one is here YC. At this point, we have Q here. This is Q, small Q here. At this point, with this value of YC here. Okay? So, with this one, we use EY curve to explain. With the change of Q, Q change, Q not constant. Okay. This is EY curve. Then I will derive this equation, okay, and then we can have a break, okay. I will derive this equation and then we can have a break. This one, what I want to show you, I want to tell you that when water coming from ordinary cross section like this, and then you have a change, small change in your cross section and narrowest here. At the narrowest point, you will have critical flow occur. That is another occurrence of critical flow. First, we see that occurrence of our critical flow occur at the crest section or at dz by dx equal to zero. Now, I will show you by using equation, by deriving equation to prove to show you that now your dB by dx change, right? At dB by dx equal to zero, or this point we call at the throat section. At this section, when dB by dx equal to zero, you will have critical flow occur. I will use the following equation to show you that when dB by dx is equal to zero, then Froude number has to be one. It means that then critical flow will occur. Okay, let's see. Beginning from definition. Definition, total energy is equal to Y plus Z plus V square over 2G. In this case, again, I like very much to prove with rectangular cross-section. So I use small Q, right? So Q equal to vy. Then I change v into q. V equal to q over y. Then I can write it like this, total energy, right? Then what else? What happened? Assuming that there is no energy loss. Assuming that there is no energy loss. I love that. Then differentiate. No energy loss, dH by dx. No energy loss, zero. So we dip dy by dx, dz by dx. In this case, it is horizontal bed. Horizontal bed. Then we dip. Let's see. This equation, this term is, this term is, has to be differentiated two terms because why? In this term, Q not constant, Y not constant. So there are two variables. So you have to differentiate two times. First, dip dy by dx and then dq by dx, right? Because Q and Y both are not constant. Then, what you get is here, we differentiate. Then, we rearrange this term. And we try to put all of the term in term of fruit number. Rearrange in term of fruit number. Fruit number is what? Remember our fruit number. Root number for rectangular cross section is V over square root dy, right? So we try to rearrange it. This is already V square. This is already V square, right? So that, let's see only this term, this one, we have equation A. Now, looking at only this term. So, Q, capital Q, constant, but small q, not constant. So, dip capital Q with respect to x, constant, so dq by dx is zero. However, dq by dx is b dq by dx plus q dB by dx because q is not constant and b is not constant. Rearrange. We got this one. Then put this one. Into first equation. What we get? Here. And then we rearrange again. Rearrange putting the term into fruit number square. Then what we have is here. And then what else? Rearrange the term. And then we try to put it in term of fruit number square again. And then what we have finally, we have this equation. What does it mean? Abstraction. Mathematically speaking, abstraction, it means that at dB by dx equal to zero, right? Then what happened when dB by dx equal to zero? Abstraction, when this one equal to zero, then all of this term is zero. Then we have only this term left. However, in reality, when you see water level passing through this point, this is YC, you have a change in water level. At this point, dy by dx is not zero. No. We can see it by eyes. It's true. but dy by dx not equal to 0 then only one possibility to make this one true that is fruit number has to be equal to 1 so it means that critical flow occurs right so briefly we derive beginning from total definition of total energy and we differentiate that one with respect to x assuming that there is no energy loss finally what we get this equation right and with this equation if we consider that when dB by dx equal to 0 then this term or of this term is 0 then because dy by dx we have a change in water level is not equal to 0 then only this term fruit number has to be 1 so when dB by dx is 0 then fruit number has to be 1 it means that at cross section critical flow occur some question do you have any questions now No? If no, then we have a break, okay? Break 15 minutes, then I come back. Okay. Okay, นะคะ ลูก Break ก่อนนะ break ก่อนนะ
ครับ
Okay, ลูก